Hello everyone, it's me Peter back after quite some time. I don't remember, I think this is my third Banter Blitz session, but the last one was some ages ago, like 1.5 years ago. In any case, I'm very, very happy to be back and very happy to take the challenge. I would like to suggest, because after all, it's a Banter Blitz, I don't think that the result is the most important. I believe that we should have as much fun as possible. If you could challenge before 3+2 or 3+1, I mean, so that we will not be flagging each other. And in this case, I can also commentate the games better. Yeah, and that's the reason. Otherwise, I would not mind. But I think the point is to discuss the games as much as possible. So let me take the first challenge, Dr. Vegas. Let's go. E4, okay, what should I do? Okay, let's stick first to E4, E5. Professional mode, but no Petrov. Okay, let's play some Spanish. Okay, let's pretend we play Magnus style. Let's play classical Spanish. Rook 6, castles, bishop E7. Rook E1, B5. Castles. And let's see. Okay, so what should I do? No, but I'm not Magnus. Okay, no, I'm Magnus. Okay, let me play bishop b7, but no rook b8. Let's not give away all the secrets. So let's stick to good old classical stuff. C3. Okay. Interesting. C3. All right, let's. What should I do? Playing the martial spirit. Okay, let me play martial spirit. Let's see what it is. Because A4, bishop B7 included, it's a little bit different martial than usual. But let's see where it leads. Rook E5. All right, so let's go bishop F6. Attacking the rook. Now, of course, there are some different rules here than the other marshal, because here I can also go knight F4 immediately. I mean, this is like shockingly good news. I mean, shockingly, now the bishop on B7 does incredible job. Hitting on g2. Well, actually, I have never seen such a good marshal. f3, and now there is a hole on d3. Very difficult to resist the temptation to step in there with the knight d3. Yeah, wow. I mean, okay, this is really looking great. I mean, yeah, okay, rook f1, so can I just play queen d6? Yeah, okay, let's increase the pressure. Queen d6, also settling some queen c5 check, bishop e5, hitting on h2. I mean, all kinds of ideas. Yeah, bishop c2, okay, I will go for queen c5 check, followed by knight f2 check. Let's go for this. Basically, now rook takes f2 is kind of forced. Yes, queen f2, and now I'm gonna hit the first rank with some rook e8. Yeah, d4, rook f8. And I'm setting rook e1 checkmate or rook e2 entering. Basically, looking pretty crushing. Rook e2. Queen g1, yeah, now the big question, I mean, I have queen takes f3, also very, very tempting. Rook takes d2. Okay, for the moment, let's stick to queen takes f3. It's kind of the most stylish choice. So gf, bishop f3, queen g2, and then, okay, rook takes g2. Ah, wow. Bishop d1, well, it doesn't really makes a difference, takes, and again this spin along the long diagonal is a big problem. I have all kinds of discover checks. Yes, thank you. At this point, so what? Ah, yes, of course. Yes. Hang on, now I'm suddenly stuck here I press the button, take new challenge, and I don't know who will be the next challenger. So hang on. All right, so let me... Dangerous ride. Okay, let's go. 3+2. There we go. Dangerous ride. Let's see how dangerous it will be. A4. Okay, A4, A6. A4, A6. G3. So this was tricky. This A4 is kind of maybe more useful than my A6. Oops. Okay, let's stick to some... wow, this is the error, I think, but this I think I have to abort. Because the game, I already started my game. Yes, no, this was some automatic choice. So, okay, I mean, definitely this game with Dangerous Ride, I will continue. But now I don't see the challenge. So, okay, first let me take another challenge and then I will come back. So, Dangerous Ride, be there. I will be back. I'll be back. And we can continue from A4, A6, G3, because that's method of principle. Unfortunately, previously I already pushed this button like get a new challenge and the computer was doing it for me. All right, so it seems like classical Spanish continues. So what do we see here? Do we see some... what it will be? There. Okay. Nice classical player. Okay, B3, my old favorite. Bishop F8, D5. Trying to block the bishop. D5, C4, C6. And A5. Okay, it seems like everybody knows everything. Everybody knows everything. Okay, what should I do? A5. Okay, let me try Bishop D3. It's kind of a typical move. If black goes A5, we can sum squares, but A4. Wow, A4. Is this possible? I saw that it's not possible. Can I play B4? And now can I take DC? And I can take CB. I mean, that's the whole point of playing Bishop DC, that I cover all these squares. So I won a pawn, but okay, how to continue? It looks very nice. Very tempting would be to go knight c4 and then knight e5, knight takes d6. The e4 pawn is hanging. So I should pay attention or just ignore. It's also very, very tempting just to ignore. Okay, maybe let's just ignore. Okay, knight c4. This move, knight c4, looks so incredibly tempting that impossible to not make it, even if it's a mistake. Yeah, knight takes e4, knight a5. That was my desire to get this knight a5 move. hitting the bishop on b7, so black has some coordinating issues, but black has one essential pawn. Yeah, that's kind of tricky. But for the moment, it's a big question that how should black try to keep his position together. I have all kinds of knight takes b7, knight c6 ideas. I mean, a lot of problems. Yeah, queen b8, and that's exactly what I meant, that knight c6 is also very, very tempting. Can go knight c6. So if bishop takes c6, b takes c6, I might get a very, very dangerous pawn there on c6. And okay, I will have the two bishops and very, very promising position. I think I will have a very promising position. Yeah, very tough to do anything. I mean, but that was the whole point of this bishop d3 move that I played. That once black played the move a6, a5, weakening the b5 square immediately, I wanted to use this. So basically, black has to take on c6, takes, and then knight d7 to f6, but then the e4 knight will be also kind of trapped. A little bit, but okay, black will get his counterplay with d6, d5. I mean, it's not over yet. Yeah, takes, knight f6, exactly, this is the way to go. Now b4 is hanging, okay, b5, I push b4, b5, and d6, d5. This is exactly what I told. How black should play, and I'm not sure if maybe my opponent is listening to me. I don't know how this whole Bunter Blitz works, that whom am I talking to. I know I'm talking to the audience, but maybe my opponent is my audience as well. I don't know. This is, in any case, tricky. I have to watch out not to run into my own tricks. So knight on f3 is not the best piece. It's not the best piece. I would love to trade it somehow. Okay, let's go knight g5. Let's challenge this knight on e4. Let's go knight g5. It would be nice to get rid of this knight. So takes. Knight e4. Okay, it's just impossible not to take on e4. This is just so tempting and so natural. Go queen d5. Rely on the two bishops. The two pass pawns, c6, b5 pawns are very, very strong. Basically, I can ignore this e5 if it's not even about the e4 pawn. I would like to go bishop c4 next. Just bring all my pieces to the center and that's it. That's it. But I have to say, I'm so not used to playing chess. I mean, pushing the clock, making a move. It's just when I'm commenting, it's so simple. Yeah, I'm just telling what I think. It's a completely different story when you have to make a move. You have to press the clock. Basically, I'm not pressing the clock, but yeah, each move is a responsibility. There are like millions of moves, millions of ideas. Okay, let me take on a8 and then follow it with c8 queen. Takes, and okay, this looks pretty much it. Bishop c4 comes as well. Now, not only piece up, but also my b pawn is, yes, my opponent resigned. So, okay, excellent. Well, it was nice that I managed to stay silent at one moment. All right, so okay, one game. Now I'm gonna take with black against Mr. Sankukai. Let's see. I do remember that I think I have already played with white against Mr. Sankukai. So I think it's fair that now I give a chance for bishop f4, London system. Okay, let me play e6. Let me try to use my favorite line with c5. CC, super solid. I think it's super solid. Okay, let me just play b6. I like this bishop b7 system. Bishop b7. Super solid stuff, of course, for white. Okay, this last move, bishop d6, it gives me the chance to go knight h5. I don't know if it's good or bad, but it's provoking me. Let me play knight h5. Let me hit this bishop. Let's see what it leads to. Bishop g3, let's not take it. Let's first stabilize, cement this knight on h5. I always like this, keeping the options when I will take on g3. The bishop is already hopefully not running away, a queen e2. So basically white is also offering the chance of going long castle, maybe somewhere. Right, so what should we do? Okay, let's play d6. Let's play d6. Somehow it looks like a flexible move. The bishop, what I wanted to say, yeah, white plays e4, but this bishop is still not running away. Let me continue, then knight d7. Let's for the moment just continue. We are basically both waiting with our kings. We don't want to decide yet. I'm also waiting for my opponent a3, then a6. All right, let's keep the opposition. Let's stick to the plan of, but sooner or later, white will have to decide, I feel, yeah, and then short castle played. In this case, now I also castle. And b4. Okay, now basically, already I think it's possible to take on g3. It's kind of okay. It's not the time to take. I want to go queen c7 next, just flexible. Now already I don't have to worry about some h-file attack, yeah, because that's why I was waiting for white to castle. And let's play b5, b6, b5. Let's grab some space. Queen e3. Okay, let's maybe even push c4, c5, c4, because I have the dark squared bishop. I mean, this dark squared bishop might be very useful. Let me play e6, e5. I'm trying to get some Spanish structure. Now also the bishop on b1 feels a bit out of the game. I just want to be very, very strategical. Yeah, queen h6, trying to create some mess. Let's ignore the mess. Rook f8. Okay, rook f8, knight g5, knight f6, f4, bishop f8. Basically, my opponent gets some chance. How much is it a chance? It's another... But I also don't even want to allow this knight g5. Actually, this knight g5 irritates me. Let me make this very, very strange looking, stupid move, queen c7 to d8. It's not a panic move. I just want to stop knight g5, f2, f4, because then maybe this bishop on b1 would get into game. Yeah, so g4 played, trying to grab the dark squares as well. But hang on, now let me try to go knight f6. Yes, I think I can go knight f6. Attacking this g4 pawn. Yeah, g5. I wanted to go knight h5. Now it all gets very, very messy. I'm also trying to target white screen. I want to trap white screen actually. Rook e8, bishop f8 is my plan. It's not so easy to stop. Yeah, now g4, I could of course jump knight f4, but it's very, very tempting just to try to trap this queen. So let me go rook e8. I will just insist on trapping this queen. Yeah, g8, bishop f8. So hg, I take on h6. And I made some good trades. Okay, bishop takes e5, it's already basically over. The smoke has cleared. I'm queen up for just a piece. Basically, it's a designable position. gh7 check. Okay, I will even ignore this. I don't need the g5. Okay, let's take. Let's give queen g5 check next and collect on the collector. Queen takes the two. So I'm already full queen up. This even for my technique should be enough. Yes, thank you. It was a solid game. Okay, let's take the Pelzi Giesel. Let's go and okay, let's still play e4. I don't know, I want to experiment as well, but for the moment let's stick to classical chess. E6. Okay, d4. Takes. Which pause and it's gonna be? Is it gonna be some pause? And yeah, bishop c5. Okay, so some tricky stuff. How did it go? So I think white can play knight c3. I think white can play this. Because this is similar like with queen b6 line. Yeah, exactly. Similar to queen b6. Knight e7. Well, it's a little bit strange. So knight b3. Bishop b6. Little bit strange. I mean, very provocative. Very, very provocative. So what do we have? Okay, let's go bishop f4. So, wow, still, I don't understand anything. Okay, so let me go bishop d6. I'm falling into all the traps. F5. So if I push e5, bishop c7, I feel like my opponent wants to trick me. I only don't know exactly how, but I clearly have the feeling that I'm running into some trap. I'm running into some trap. I'm expanding too much, but okay. Yeah, knight c6. It's kind of tricky. So what is the trap? Okay, let's play queen d2. Let's try to play normal. A5. Okay, that's the idea. So my opponent wants to come. Okay, a5, a4. Let's block it. Let's block it. After all, I got the b5 square. So it's something for something, as usual. Chess is like this. Something for something. I give the b4 square, but I would like, yeah, f5, f4, trying to isolate my pawn. Okay, let me cancel, look f5. Wow. I mean, my opponent wants to hit my e5 pawn. Can I keep it? Okay, for the moment, let's go bishop d3. Let's make a developing move. Let's develop. I mean, it feels like black will have to sacrifice some material, I mean, some exchange or something. That's at least what my intuition tells me. Because if he hangs on to material, then it might be very, very unpleasant. I don't know. But it's a strange structure. I mean, I have never seen something like this. I mean, 30 moves and black has a pawn on f4, bishop on b6, hitting my f2 pawn, but I also have this incredible bishop on d6. That's why I'm saying like somehow to sacrifice an exchange, but it's easier said than done. It's not so obvious how black should sacrifice. I'm developing. For the moment, I'm developing. Queen f8, yeah, there we see the sacrifice, yeah. It's in the spirit. Okay, sooner or later I will have to take. So takes, rook he1 would be logical. Yeah, basically it's very logical. Bringing the pieces. Yeah, and knight g6, yeah. Black does everything correctly, absolutely correctly. Now maybe it would be nice to get rid of this, challenge this f4 pawn. I don't know exactly Because I also weakened the Fc square. Yeah, it's wow. Knight before what? Queen takes c2. It's just a check. It's not checkmate. It's not checkmate. This is good news. So let me maybe go rook e4. Maybe go rook e4. Also, I close this. But then knight a2 check. Yeah, I have the temptation to give this, but maybe I should not give this. Maybe let's just play king b1. I mean, this is always a nice little move. Whenever you castle along, then okay, king b1. At least if I blunder something on c2, it's going to be a check, not checkmate. That's already something. And still, black has to develop the bishop. Of course, if black somehow gets this light square bishop, I mean, imagine the bishop from c8 reaching g6, hitting on c2, it would be very, very serious. Rook a6 comes immediately. I would also like to play rook e4, somehow challenging this f4 pawn, challenging something. Also hitting the b4 knight. But I don't think that I want to get rid of this. Yeah, fg, fg. Let's take fg, fg. And now the f file opened. I feel like the f file opened for me. I have two rooks here, knight d5. Let me play rook c4. It's kind of nice hitting the bishop on c8. It feels like very, very unpleasant. Might be decisive. Looks like I'm crushing now. Because how to keep there? If black takes on c3, yeah, and black designed. All right. Okay, that was smooth. After all, it was smooth. It was smooth. So let's see. Let's see what else do we have. I see a lot of challenges. Thank you very much for all your challenges. I'm now scrolling because I feel like there was this dangerous ride. We started some game and yes, dangerous ride. So we have to make that right. Let's go. That game has to be played. And a4, a6, g3, I think that would be fair play if we start with a4, a6, g3, because that's how the game, yes, a4, a6, correct. And b3, the big novelty. Okay, this is big novelty, definitely big novelty. I feel like I got out prepared. I thought like g3 will happen. Now, okay, but now I can play e5. Let me try to use the move a6. Let me try to make good use of a6. Okay, I can in this case develop knight to c6. And okay, now just normal moves. Let's make some normal moves. Okay, let's go h5. Yes, I wanted to get this g4 square, bishop g4 quickly, just to see, because this bishop on g4 is quite annoying. But if white plays fc, then it further weakens white's construction. So what do we have? d3. Aha, my opponent wants to use the famous hippopotamus. Wow, okay, so what should we do? Should we take the challenge? Okay, first let's play normal chess, bishop c5. First let's play normal chess after we see what to do next. Why did I play bishop c5? I don't know. Sometimes when I talk, then I just make some move, but okay, in general, bishop c5 is very, very natural. I was just not sure if this is really what the position requires. But yeah, I have so many options. I don't know where should I castle. Okay, for the moment, I'm going to castle short. I castle short. So castles happened. All right, so rook e8. Just making some natural moves, bringing the rooks to the center. First, let's see and wait what white does. Yeah, white has to kind of confirm his ideas. Usually in the hippo, people try to keep the pawn on h3. I don't know, this pawn on h4 gives me all kinds of possibilities. For example, knight d4 now is a very tempting option. I can hardly even hold myself back. If I can get the task for a bishop, I cannot say no to that. I basically just cannot say no to that. This dark square bishop, I mean, if bishop takes d4, and then I will get the chance to move my bishop back, this will be a lovely bishop. This will be a lovely bishop. Rook e1, wow. Okay, this shows respect. This shows respect that the bishop is a bishop, but rook is a rook. I mean, okay, let me then take the exchange, and not just the exchange, but also I get some g4 square. I can get play knight g4, hitting on f2 as well. I mean, I have all kinds of possibilities. Yeah, rook f1, of course, I don't want to. I don't want to give up my light pieces. I will not take on f2. It would lead to this strange disbalance of three minor pieces versus two rooks. I don't want to find that out, figure that out. It's simply unnecessary. I'm exchange up. I have the better position. I have the winning position. Why should I do anything crazy? I could have taken on e4, but I just prefer to play as classical as possible. Keep the center, keep the tension. In this case, also the knight on d2 will not get immediately a nice outpost on e4. Okay, bishop h3, rook a d8 played. Kind of all natural. And now the big question, what is the follow-up? How does my opponent want to follow it up? It's logical to play for f2 fc, but it's not so easy because king g2 still does not threaten fc because of knight c3 and knight fc is played. Now maybe it's the time to take on e4. And I feel like now it's the time the knight moved. I can take on e4, queen e4, and play queen d5. I mean, that very much fits into all the rules of chess. I could have taken knight f2 and play for some fancy business, but I just did not feel like calculating. I mean, I'm exchange up. There is just no need to calculate anything. Let's take the queens. I take a g and I'm going to enter with rook d2. And basically, once you know that you can do this, there is no need to look for anything else. You know that this is winning. I mean, if you are exchange up and your rooks start to play, you get open files, then there is just no way it's not going to work. So let's not calculate any nonsense. Just entering. Rook d2. Yeah, what to do with? I mean, f2 is weak. Yeah, now the c2 pawn is falling. Also, rook takes e4 is coming. White's position just falls apart. Bishop e5, f6. Rook takes e4. Is the good thing is that the knight on g4 protects the f2 pawn, but I mean, basically, it just doesn't matter. I'm exchange up. Yeah, trying to. Okay, let's go. My opponent wants to go. I know, okay, he just wants to play. Okay. Let's trade. Rook c5. Rook takes h5. Collecting material. Let's bring this rook back. Rook takes b4. The fork is not the end of the world because I just ignore it. Takes, takes. King d5. Chop, chop. Knight d6, d5. Yes, okay, so we had this big battle, the prestige battle had to be played. It had to be played with dangerous ride. All right. So please challenge me 3+2. I mean, I really would prefer to take the challenge on in 3+2. Okay. Anshuman Mishra. What is it? This is 3-0. Okay, it's only 3-0, but I think Anshuman challenged me in 2 games, 1-3+2, 3-0, and I thought I picked the 3-2, but no, it was the wrong one. Okay, so what is this? Some classical stuff. Bishop DC 92. It's kind of always the famous old classical stuff, but okay, let's do something different. Now also my opponent played with Bishop E6, kind of giving me this temptation to go for some attack with H4. There is some target there. And it's 3+0, so this is a tough game. I mean, no time to think. I'm still complete Pacersky with flagging business. I just don't have any experience. I just don't play this. So I have to try to mate my opponent as quickly as possible. And I think I will get a chance, because now Bishop takes G6 comes next. And Black's position falls apart. Queen takes G6, checkmate. Wow, okay, that's how I prefer to finish a game 3-0, because the tension is too high. The tension is just too high. Okay, I see Captain Evans has changed his 3-0 to 3+2. I was the one who offered it, so we have to battle it out. Let's see, one more classical Spanish. No, Italiano. Okay, this is gonna be some. No. What kind of Italiano? This is Evans Gambit. All right, Evans Gambit. Okay, in my old times, I used to play Bishop B6, the good old Bishop B6. The only problem is I forgot everything. How was it? What was it? Why was it? Good question. A4. Okay, so if I play A5, B5, Knight D4 also looks kind of natural, but okay, let's play A6. Let's play A6. C3. Okay, so basically we are now going towards Italian structure. Yeah, D3, D6. So, but okay, white achieved something, because I was forced to put my bishop on b6. Yeah, so in this case, white has gained something, but I'm not sure how relevant it is, because I have my play. Yeah, I have my typical play, I have my ideas. I'm in chilling mode. I don't want to get into any messy stuff and get checkmated, you know, and then everybody will be laughing. No need for checkmate. Let's play H6. Let's just play H6. H3, knight E7, okay. Classical moves. The typical classical moves, knight E7, knight G6 maneuver, very, very standard, very famous. In Italians, in Spanish, it's always the most natural. Wow, b4, b5. So my opponent immediately wants to do something. Okay, let me take on b5. I don't know yet where does this lead. Should I be afraid of this? I don't have the feeling that I should be afraid. And knight g6. Let's stick to the plan. Never change the winning team. Knight g6. I'm going to go c6, knight h5 already. Who is playing for attack? Okay, a6, b6. I mean, I can also just take, yeah. If white takes, then finally I have bishop takes f2 trick. So yeah, bishop c4 played. Now what should I do? I mean, basically I want a pawn. I want a pawn. I don't know if, was it a brilliant sacrifice or was it just some kind of a blunder? I don't know exactly. Bishop is still b8. What is happening here? Queen a2. Okay, I just, I'm gonna push a5. I keep my pawn. And maybe now it's time to start action. Action time, knight h5. That's also kind of typical. Whenever you have knight g6, the same applies when you have knight on g3, then you go knight h4, knight f5. In the Ruy Lopez now, I'm also trying similar ideas. Yeah, knight b3, hitting my a5 pawn. You know what? I just ignore it. I go knight hf4. I don't care about this pawn. I really want to create something on the king side. I feel like now it's time. Queen f6 comes as well. All my pieces coming. Setting all kind of knight takes g2s, knight takes h3s, whatever. It's very, very ugly spot for white to deal with all these issues. Yeah, knight h2, and okay, knight already feels like, I mean, knight h2 is super tempting. Knight h2, king h, king g2, knight h4 check, king h1, bishop takes h3, rook g1, knight f3, and all these things are looking super, super shaky. But I don't know. I mean, it looks winning. There is also knight g2, king g2, knight h4 check, king g3 coming up with the king. And then all kinds of mating ideas I have there, but do they really mate? I'm not 100% sure. And besides, I could also just, I also have this move knight h4, very, very tempting. I mean, it's super tempting just to play knight h4 as well. No, also queen g5, actually queen g5 looks also very, very strong. Yeah, maybe I will just play queen g5. How will white protect on g2? I'm not 100% sure. But yeah, there are all kinds of all this tactical motive. Just if there is no need to sacrifice something, then why should we sacrifice? We should play according to demands of the position. So g3. Let's take bishop takes. Why should we sacrifice if we don't need to sacrifice, right? So actually, if we take Khan, then I'm two pawns up and I have the attack. Yeah, this is quite a nice situation. But okay, one should not carry the way, yeah, because when you think you are completely winning and then things are not that clear after all, then it's a bit tricky. So okay, let me. Should I play bishop e6? Let me play bishop. Knight takes a5. Okay, hang on. So can I take? I think I can take bishop takes a5. Takes. And now I'm gonna go rook b1 check. And this was the whole point. And okay, now knight h3 check. So queen h5 is very tempting. I mean, this is all kinds of mate are looming in there. Knight h3 check. King h2, queen h5, king g2, then knight h4 check. This is also check. And this is already too much to handle. Knight f3 check comes as well. It's what? I only have 3 seconds. This is not 3+2. What is it? What is happening? What is happening? I'm talking here. And in fact, I'm about to lose on time. Wow. Okay, so let me just finish this here. Yeah. Okay, wow. I mean, when I last looked, it was like we both had 1 minute each. How did this time disappear so quickly? I don't know. This really surprises me. Good that I looked, because I just did not notice at all that it might be so tricky. I was enjoying my position. All right. Min Sabi 90. Let's take a look. So e4. All right. So what should we do? Okay. Let's stick to this classical Spanish. I think it's also very nice to explain. Yeah, there is a lot to explain. Classical opening, all these ideas. Bishop c4, bishop c5. So will we see another Evans Gambit, or will it be an Italian? Yeah, castles, knight f6. So do we see some? Yeah, this is the classical Italian. Okay. So very, very similar structure, d3, d6. I'm expecting c3. I mean, white usually plays with c3, but there is also the knight c3 concept. But usually c3 is the main. Usually c3 is the main. Yeah, exactly, c3. So let me castle. This is the main tabia of... I mean, of course, instead of castles, one can also play h6 to stop any kind of bishop g5, but I'm never the guy who is worried of bishop g5. I'm welcoming bishop g5, but if white plays h3, then I can do h6. Basically, once white plays h3, it indicates me that he doesn't want to play bishop g5. So I'm not doing h6 because of bishop g5. I just know that white will probably play this classical style. And okay, I also get ready for classical style. Again, knight e7, knight g6. I stepped out with bishop c5. If white wants to go d3, d4, I wanted to step out of it. Now that I did it, I feel like I'm doing fine. Knight h4, stopping knight g6. Very, very unpleasant, nasty, but now I'm going to go c6, d5. Now I told you that I like knight g6. My opponent said, okay, if Peter likes it, I will not give him. But in this case, I will use the chance to expand in the center with d6, d5. Queen e2. Okay, so what does it mean? Okay, rook e8. This rook belongs to e8. Guards the e-pawn. King h1. So does white really want to go f4. Okay, then let's go g5. Okay, now I feel like white really provoked me, because with knight h4 he's losing time. g5, it's not a weakening. Next, I'm going to go knight g6, and in fact, I will be the one who will get the attack. It's very, very dangerous position for white. Also, the queen on e2. With knight g6, knight f4, I might come with tempo. The knight from d2 cannot really move, because the rook on f1 is still hindering the f1 square. Yeah, that's why usually white plays rook e1 to be able to play knight f1 to get harmony. But at this moment, there is the chance for white to run the risk of not getting any harmony anymore. And yeah, that's how it goes in classical openings. Yeah, you basically know the rules. You understand what you are doing, why you are doing. You get all the harmony. And if you get the harmony, and everything works for you, yeah, that's actually the point. That's why I really love these kind of things. And then the combinations, the tactics will come to you. There is no need for you to run after them. They will run to you. G5, G4. By far, no, not obligatory. But I just feel like, okay, my pieces are so active. I just want to try to use my activity. But I had so many other positional, nice little moves. I just already wanted more. Okay, knight g1. This was a very clever move. This is a very nice move. kind of had to be played. Okay, I can take on h3, but then I give the fc square. I don't want to give the fc square. I feel like I don't want to give the fc square for white's knight. But how do I increase the pressure? Don't want to take there. Okay, let me move this knight. I'd like to move this knight, but then g3 comes. Okay. So this knight g1 little irritates me because it's a good reaction. So should I just, okay, I will just ignore, I will now just play very professional, just h5 to make sure that after ag I will take ag. I still don't want white to really develop his knight from d2. Just keep the tension, keep the pressure. Yeah, g3, correct. And I insist on keeping the tension. So I just keep the tension. Queen g2, I will develop the bishop to e6. Yeah, now it's a different phase. The game takes a different phase. White has survived the assault, but I was actually not really trying to mate or finish the game quickly. I just wanted to play my game. So it's not at all connected with checkmate ideas. All right, I have now, again, some possibilities which look tempting. Actually, very difficult not to take on. I mean, d4, bishop e6, rook e6, d4, queen d3 would be my very, very first instinct just to play like this. Very difficult not to play like this. It's so much in the, so much according to the position. So I could also take on h3, take on f2. It's also possible, also kind of tempting. Okay, let me do it. Now I'm giving up on everything what I have told before. And in fact, if I wanted to do this, I should have done one move earlier. But okay, I noticed it too late. I was talking too much, enjoying myself. Because I did not want to take the pawn. I wanted to, I did it because I wanted to use this knight g4, and this is what I completely missed before, that I have this option. So check, okay, bishop moves back. I have won a piece. Just have to make sure not to run into any tricks. Now the knight is hanging. Hang on, I almost forgot about all these spins that this knight is hanging. Queen f6 protects. Knight takes d4. Knight f5. Queen g5. Just trade the queens and I'm peace up. Knight a6 check. Okay, we ignore it. King f8. And after takes. So peace up. The bishop on a2 is cut. Let's open up the game. Ed4. And white lost on time, but also I think he would have resigned. So, okay, the classical chess works. Classical chess still works. All right. FIDE Arena GM. Okay, FIDE Arena GM. Okay, let's go. Let's go. Let's see what it is. Let's see what it is. Knight f6, knight f6. Which opening will it be? Which opening will it be? Okay, so this is Torre attack. Is this Torre attack? What is my main reaction against this? Yeah, you don't play chess and you forget everything. It's unbelievable. Unbelievable. When you are working as a second, this is completely different. You are working on someone else's repertoires, move orders, plus you also don't want to reveal his kind of stuff. And then you forget everything, what you supposed to do and what you were planning to do. Okay, it took me some 30 seconds to come up with C5. Congratulations. How does this go? I go Qb6. Let's see, Qb6. This is very, very special. Yeah, Bishop f6. So it's super special. Just gf6. Super special. It's kind of some mixed Klompowski or what is it? I even don't know. Queen c1. Yeah, let's go f5. I even don't know how to call this, how to name this. We are both doing normal moves. Knight c6. Just wanted to bring the knight to e7. Knight c4, queen c7. Some strategical battle. Knight c5. Okay, let me castle. I hope I will not get checkmated. I really hope I will not get checkmated. So knight. Okay, let's kick this knight away. And now let's go e6, e5. I mean, I have quite a flexible structure. Yeah, I have the double pawns, but these double pawns are doing me some good. D5, d5. I mean, and I have the two bishops. One should not forget about this. Two bishops are two bishops. So I have now all kinds of tempting options. Okay, let's go c5, c4. Bishop e6. Let's develop before deciding what to do with the nice construction. But actually, I have a pretty nice construction. Yeah, e4. Okay, so e4. Let me just ignore it with b5. I want to guard this c4 pawn. I want to guard the pawn. And just bring the pieces. Just bring the pieces. Yeah, okay, white plays correct. Of course, yeah, this is very nice. Okay, so let me take on e4. I would like to jump to d5. Knight d5. I want to go knight f4. And if g3, I might go f5. That's kind of the point. And then also some problems. Of course, it's also weakening, but very difficult to say no to a move like this. And then even play e5, e4. I mean, just take control of all the squares that I can. Looking promising, knight g6. Yeah, white tries to create counterplay. Okay, rook f6. Why not? Yeah, and now also, I feel like I would love to play knight f4. I really love to play knight f4. Can I play knight f4? Okay, let's play knight f4. That I can. My pieces are just so active that I feel like Maybe it was not necessary. I mean, definitely it was not necessary. Just was so difficult and not to do it. Yeah, rook e1. Also, I have so many tempting options just to take or just to play knight d3. And basically, knight d3 is also super, super tempting. Let's go knight d3 takes and takes with a pawn. Takes with cd. So I have the two bishops. I have this incredible powerful pawn chain. But yeah, white got the f4 square. So let me also fight with h5, bishop h6. I want to fight against this knight on f4. But at least white also activated his pieces. White has activated the pieces. King h1. Okay, so I have different ways to play. Okay, first let's push h4. I mean, this is very, very tempting. Knight e3 played. So what does it mean? I mean, I have d2. Hang on, because the idea was takes queen f4, some knight d5, but it also doesn't work. But I can just play d2, and it's basically game over. Looks like it is game over. Yeah, it is game over. So, all right, it was a big battle, but it worked out well for me against Fidel in a GM. So what else do we have? Let me take a look. And thank you very much for so many challenges. It's really nice. It's really nice. So, okay, whom should I? I mean, I have seen Crypto was here right from the beginning. Let's take the challenge against Mr. Crypto. I have noticed him right from the very, very beginning. What? And I got no rating, yeah? As I see, I got no rating for the previous game. Wow. But that was the reason why I took the challenge against a very, very dangerous player so that I can try to increase my rating. But no, I got nothing for it. All right. That's how it goes. So then let's say that it's just nice to have fun, a lot of fun without the pressure of rating or whatsoever. Let's play this nice little classical English. Bishop h5. I think there was a time when people were saying that this bishop g5 is super clever and super smart. I never understood it. To be honest, I never understood it because to my eyes, this h6, g5 expansion, I really enjoy. I mean, I'm super happy with it from the black side. I gain space. Okay, maybe I will be proven wrong, but for the moment, I'm happy. For the moment, I'm still very, very happy. Rook b1, yeah, it's all classical. Rook b1, rook b8. I'm going to go b6 and bishop b7. I don't mind this. Oops. Okay, I blundered actually knight takes g5, but I would have called it a planned blunder because I had a lot of interesting ideas there after ag and then king f8 and then knight e5, knight g4 and go for attack. All right, so now also I'm very tempted to play for d4 square. Yeah, this is, I also haven't castled yet. I'm combining now play. I'm doing very nicely strategically. I mean, everything as it should be. Knight c2. Yeah, of course, white is also bringing his knight. Let me go knight g6 to e5. I still like to keep knight on c6 to have an option to jump into d4. Yeah, queen e2. So after queen e2, it's clear that White will not give me knight d4 ever, so let me use this moment for h4. I'm trying to make good use of not having castled yet. Yeah, this is a nice little advantage for me. I can try to play total chess. Yeah, b5, of course, kicking away the knight. Now the big question is, should I keep the tension or is it feels like now it's already time to jump in. I mean, knight d4, knight takes d4, cd4. I mean, my position looks just overwhelming, to be honest. I mean, it really looks terrible for white. Yeah, knight d1, queen f6 also looks super, super natural. Just queen f6. Bishop f4, yeah, correct. Well, I actually just wanted to play bishop h6, but for the moment I play queen g6. Reinforcing the pawn on g4, yeah, because it was clear that takes takes will happen. But now look at this knight on d1. This knight from d1 cannot really be activated. This knight has nowhere to go. If white would have played knight e2, then at least knight b4, knight c6 or some play. But now this knight on d1 looks dead almost for the rest of the game. Unless white will go knight b2, sacrifice the pawn with c5 and try to get knight c4. But okay, it comes at the cost of a very healthy pawn. And my position will be still super solid. I mean, now with this bishop on e5, I have all these attacks on the h-file also. I can play queen h5, ask one little question, and this king on g1 might end up in a terrible trouble. Really, white seems to be in big trouble too. And my play is just very, very easy. I don't know what to suggest for white. It looks strategically lost. I mean, it really looks strategically lost. Yeah, f4, very sad choice, but what to do? Now after gf, the g3 pawn v4. Yeah, okay, h3, but in this case, we'll just reinforce my position, rook h4, king e7, rook b8. I'm just bringing all my pieces, and it seems like the near is very, very close. But okay, it's not so easy to break through, but basically the game is over already. Yeah, rook e1, just gonna go king e7. And in this case, rook f4. There is no escape. There is no escape, just winning the queen. Yeah, that's exactly what I meant with this bishop g5. White provoked this h6 g5, but I'm very, very happy. I mean, usually even in the Italian, I was saying that like bishop g5, h6, bishop h4, I'm ready to go g5, and I'm a big, big believer in this type of positions. But here I even had a super, super nice construction. Yeah, so many challenges. Okay, so what should I? Chessy 96. Okay, I mean, our dog's name is Chessy. I cannot not accept the challenge of Chessy 96. Our dog, Chessy, a small chihuahua with the name Chessy. Okay, bishop b5 check. A solid choice. I mean, really incredible what the journey this bishop b5 check has done. Its reputation has grown tremendously. Usually, like 20, 30 years ago, when I was just starting out, people called bishop b5 the lazy approach. Well, it might still be a lazy approach, but it doesn't mean that white is not trying to play for advantage or something. It's just to avoid any kind of theory, just get a nice game, control the center, and and have the easy game. Bishop e7, knight c3. Now, in such moments, there are questions that should black play knight e5 or not. White gets knight d4. We are getting this muddled structure. Takes, takes. a6, yeah, all fairly standard. Okay, rook fd1. So very standard move. Yeah, rook c8. I go a4. Yeah, black tries to attack the c4 pawn. I had to play a4 because black was setting knight e5, beastly b5 using the pin. Yeah, now after knight e5, beastly, I'm controlling the b5 square. Knight c6 played. Now the question, should I trade? I mean, just develop bishop e3, or should I try to keep all the pieces on the board? But I mean, I will not be able to, in long terms, avoid any kind of trades. So let's trade it on my terms. Knight d4, bishop d4. I will have lovely construction with bishop on d4, knight c3. What else can we ask for? Queen c7. Okay, so let's go rook c1. Rook d8. Okay, let's play h3. But hang on, we always have to calculate, is d5 a threat already or not? I guess not yet. So I will just play h3. Natural little move. Of course, also a very typical idea from white side to go knight d5, cdd, but then knight takes d4, hits my queen. That's actually one thing I have to pay attention. After rook d7, I somehow would love to clarify this issue. Okay, let me play queen d2. I was actually very happy with the queen on e2, but yeah, queen b8, correct. Of course, I might regret playing this queen d2 move. A little bit strange. Now I'm reshuffling the pieces. Now I'm putting rook on e1. I don't know what I'm doing, but I think it's like a human nature to justify the reason why I played the move queen d2. I think it's probably for this reason. So I feel like, yeah, black is trying to get ready for d6, d5. But I'm still not sure if black is ready to do that. Because I have my own ideas. So let me go rook cd1. I'm still not sure that black can play d5. This is now battle of beliefs. Maybe he can, but I somehow have the feeling that black should not be able to play d5 here. My pieces are ready. Some EDD, bishop f4, yeah, d5, we might be seeing this. So what I had in mind was to take ED. And after ED to go bishop f4. That's what I have counted on. And bishop f4. Let me check this. I feel like my pieces are very active. Yeah, bishop d6. And now I felt like I will take and knight f5. That was my original intuition. Let's see if intuition deceives me or it's correct, because I feel like black has some back rank issues. Yeah, rook d6, knight f5. Rook d7 and now cd5. That's exactly how I felt that I should be able to play. And if takes, then I just take everything and I will get the two rooks versus queen. I mean, it's, yeah, knight d5 already had to be played, knight d5, and we go for this. Boom, boom, boom. Yeah, g6. Now, looking very, very promising to me. I mean, let me go knight d6. This knight on d6 also looks wonderful. Knight on d6 looks wonderful. I mean, the two rooks seems to be very powerful. Yes, screen system, correct. I have so many tempting options, but for some reason I feel like I want to play the move g3. I cannot really explain why, but somewhere this queen f4 move was disturbing me. Just wanted to get this construction. I wanted to get this construction. Yeah, queen b4. Maybe I'm just gonna go king g2. Of course, now suddenly black screen activated itself. I'm not sure that I played the most precise, but still it looks good enough. Knight a5. Going for my bc pawn, but I mean, I really believe that now I can go against white's king. I mean, I should be able to go against white's king. I mean, black's king, pardon me. Rook e8, check, rook e7, hitting on f7. I mean, okay, I have two rooks. One of them now on the seventh rank. Queen takes b3. So with the idea that, okay, I will take anyway on f7. We check. And now I'm gonna play rook e5. I mean, I can even take the knight, but I feel like, okay, I will just take the knight. Hang on. First we collect the knight. Queen b6. Oops, queen b6. Rook d5, queen c6. And no tactics works for me. Wow. I mean, that's insane. So basically I have to, what? Okay, then I just play like this. Basically this case, then I just play like this. Well, this has not exactly gone according plans, but I mean, it's still looking good enough. And gone. This is a little bit crazy. What has happened here? Let's sidestep all these things. Let's get the control. After all, I have the seventh rank in my rook. Yes, and that's it. I mean, okay, but you see, I somehow I did not even notice that the knight on e5 was hanging. Maybe it was better just not to take. I got hesitant, I took it, and suddenly after queen b6, I got some psychological problems. This happens often, actually. All right, we have some GM, SV by chess, new chess. Let's figure it out. Let's play against the GM. Let's see what it brings us. Some battle. Again, some Sicilian. Okay, let's go for some Rosso Limo. E6, okay, castles. Knight e7, super solid weapon. Yeah? Shot and phone. Yeah, takes d4. I think there is something like this. Cd4, knight d4. There are all kinds of different reactions here. Queen c7. Wow, I mean, queen c7 looks really strange. I feel like, you know, some knight takes e6, super tempting. I mean, I just can hardly resist from playing knight takes e6. I'm expecting some trick or Knight e6, bishop e6, queen d5, knight b4, rook e6, fe6, queen e6. I mean, also looks super, super promising. Okay, I just cannot resist. Sorry, guys, I just cannot resist for this. I mean, takes, takes. Looking very promising. Just bishop e7. Okay, so basically, black sacrificed the pawn. I would love to take on e6. I mean, I really love to take on e6, but should I take? Otherwise, black is coming with some knight d4 ideas, but I mean, I'm pawn up, but rook e6, fe6, queen e4, but I'm not developed yet, yeah? This is the trick, yeah, that I'm not developed. Okay, so let's just play move knight queen e4. I'm still not sure if my opponent did not just blunder this pawn, so why not to just play normal? Queen e4, knight c3. Pawn is a pawn. I just should try to develop. Okay, that one. To play almost bishop c4 was also very tempting. But bishop f4 also very tempting. See if I move this. Somehow, okay, bishop c4 is super tempting to me. I don't know why. Maybe it's a strange move, maybe it's a bad move. Just felt like going bishop c4 looks natural. I have to pay attention to time, yeah? Bishop d6, exactly, because I was counting on, oh my God, yeah, I was counting on bishop f4 next. But now after this move, I cannot do this. So let me go knight d5. Things are getting completely crazy. Yeah, that's, I mean, I told you, bishop c4, I felt like, yeah, I shouldn't be playing, but it was so tempting. I couldn't resist, and I'm regretting. I'm already heavily regretting my choice. I did not manage to develop the bishop. This a little bit unfortunate. So I have to speculate, yeah. Queen d8, let's develop bishop e3. I want to finish my development. Yeah. Finish my development at all cost. Queen d8, bishop e3. I also want to go rook ad1. Just one more move, rook ad1, then all my pieces will be in the game. Yeah, knight e5, what does it change? What does it change? I still want rook d1. Knight c4, queen c4. Okay. Rook d1, then rook d1, then bishop g4. That is this bishop g4 move. Slightly disturbing. Okay, let me just move my bishop to b3. Too many things are hanging. I'm not happy about this. That's simply too many things are hanging. Bishop b3, trying to stabilize. But still, my queen is a little bit shaky. The big question is now also, what can black do? Can black try to initiate a knight g6 played? So I would love to move in the queen, but okay, let's play rook ad1 first. I don't see yet where this bishop can move, so bringing the rook to d1 looks logical. Queen b8. Yeah, if h3, bishop takes h3. So that was the trick. That was the idea. Okay, so let me play g3. It looks like I'm active enough to deal with all kinds of tricks. Bishop d7 played. Where should I put this queen? This queen is still a problem. Okay, let me bring it back to g2. Bishop c6, correct, clever. I have to say clever. Okay, f4. I want to grab some space. And also I want to get this queen away from this g2, from this h1a diagonal. Yeah, b5, also clever. But now I have knight f6 check. I have to use this. I have to use the momentum to solve this problem tactically. D5. Now suddenly everything works for me. The opponent wants to create some. It was clever. Yeah, it was very clever. Oops. The clock is ticking down. Hang on. The clock is ticking down. Have to watch out. Have to watch out. Yes, I'm coming. Bishop d1, trapping the queen. Yeah. All right, well, it was, there was some tricky moment there. There was some tricky moment there. So I definitely need a little bit quieter final. Okay, Mr. Quiz Monster, let's check it out. Let's check it out against Quiz Monster. E4, E5, okay, let's stick to the good old gold, classical Spanish. Seems to me like everybody is like an expert on these finesses already, but there are plenty. There are plenty of finesses. Okay, already I had one game with a4, bishop b7, d3. Okay, let's play d6. What did Magnus do? Did he play with h6 or rook e8, h6? Okay, let me try to remember what Magnus was doing. I mean, if Magnus felt like it's good for a world championship match, then let me try in Bunter Blitz. But he knew what he was doing. that's the big trick. Because, yeah, there are all these finesses. I also feel like, you know, this Quiz Monster is a real monster. I mean, I do feel like this will be some crazy battle of finesses. Knight gc, bishop f8. I don't know. I never exactly know how it works. Yeah, that everybody is so strong already, or what is happening? Knight gc, bishop f8. I still, yeah, seriously. I mean, everything is done on the highest level. I mean, absolutely highest level. All right. So now I'm going to switch to knight a5. I think Magnus would probably approve. I'm not sure, but probably. Bishop a to c5. I mean, after all, this is in the spirit. I got some Zaitsev structure, Zaitsev Chigorin, but I mean, why didn't get to push this d4 and so on? Looks like a good version to me. Yeah, knight f5, typical move, but it's not exactly what I really have to be worried of, I guess. Because in the previous game, I was attacking myself, but I'm not sure that here this is so dangerous. So queen c7. Let me play queen c7. But of course, it's a very, very legitimate move, very much in the spirit. I'm also counting on somewhere to go c5, c4, blocking this bishop. I really feel like, you know, this c5, c4, whenever there is a bishop on a2, it feels very nice. It's smiling on me, yeah? Just you want to shut this bishop out, which puts so much pressure on the epsilon pawn. And I'm also asking some questions to the e4 pawn. I mean, there are all kinds of questions there. All kinds of questions there, how to deal with this from white side. And black is harmonious. I mean, that's again how classical Spanish can look like if you really get a nice version. Yeah. White has done all the thematic natural moves, and all of a sudden, if black is in time to regroup, then everything works to perfection. G4, bravo. I think that the position really called for G4. It's probably the best move in the position. It doesn't mean that it's the position is good. It means actually that probably the position is not good, but it's absolutely justified. And I'm also insisting on the most principal reaction of flank attack should be countered by a central strike at G5. All on the highest level, I have to say. I have to say all this is on the highest level. Yeah, it takes. Now, I feel like I would love to get rid of this knight. I mean, with G6. I feel like I should get rid of this knight with G6. This knight on F5 is a monster. And G6, if goes, then I will always have bishop G7 ideas. I mean, let's put this bishop there on G6, yeah, queen F3 played, correct. I will also play rook AD8, so we are all making the natural good move. AB5, okay, AB5, queen from C7 protects the A5 knight. So I'm not feeling myself under any pressure. And the big question is, yeah, that when and how should I suddenly open up the center? Because I would love to keep the tension, but so not so simple to keep the tension. Okay, but I will. I mean, I take, I go knight c4. I did not want to take on e4. I insist on playing as harmoniously as possible. I mean, knight c4, queen f3, and now I feel like the moment has come to take on e4. I mean, now with the knight on c4, closing everything, knight takes e4, and f5 is coming as well. Everything just as a switch was. Watch. I mean, everything works as was planned. And it seems like it's time to cash in. But queen g2, okay, so is there any threat? I don't think so. I mean, it's just one queen. Attacking, I can of course go queen f7, and I believe that my opponent is forced to trade the queens. The big question is, do I want to trade queens? All right, let's trade it, let's keep it simple. No, of course, yeah, I'm piece up, so my opponent does not want to trade, but okay, now then let me invade. Rook d3, bishop e3. Uh-huh. So my opponent still wants to trick me. And I feel like my opponent wants to trick me. Okay, let me play rook f8. Yes, and now I felt like maybe it's time to take on e3. But okay, why should I? Why should I take? But otherwise, then what I was doing is a little bit stupid. I mean, I'm not absolutely happy with all my choices that I have made here. My opponent is trying to triple. Yeah, somehow it's irritating. Somehow it's slightly irritating, all this. Bishop g5. Okay, let's keep it Yeah, everything is coming. Everything is coming. Okay, let me open this up easily. Yes, I can take. Now we see this bishop from A2 is causing me so much trouble. I mean, really, it causes me so much trouble because, okay, I'm rook up, whole rook up, and still there is some intrigue in the position. Yes, okay, I have to. Check. And we'll give a check. Counter attack. Yes, that's it. Wow. I mean, okay. It was crazy and it wasn't smooth. I mean, it should have been much, much more smooth than it turned out. I don't know. Let me play some more game. Let me. All right. From India. I have so many fans and so many friends as well in India. Let's have a fight against an Indian colleague, Mr. Siddharthyan. Yeah, I don't know. It's a little bit complicated. This name is way too complicated for me. But I mean, big respect for India, for Indian chess. There is no way we should not play against Indians. But what is happening? Do I have an opponent or what is happening? I'm a little bit worried. I feel like maybe we have to abort this game. Yeah, I just don't get any answer. I have to abort. Yes, sorry. Suddenly. Okay, from United States, precious boy. All right, let's play something. Let's see, but what is happening? I mean, my opponents are running away or? Ah, no, here we go, e4. Okay, let's stick to this. If it works, it works. I mean, why should I? Ah, okay, scotch. This is not scotch. All right, let's play sharp. I'm ready to play sharp. So which line will it be? Yes, e4, bishop a6. b3, g6. And this is a classical line. Very, very classical. Bishop g7. Bishop b2, castles. This feels like some very, very old classical stuff. Bishop h3. Usually they play bishop g2. I mean, what is this? What is the difference? Okay, rook a8 looks very natural. Castles. So the trick is that d7 pawn is kind of hanging somewhere. Uh-huh. So trick stuff. I remember that there was this trick, but remember that it was also not working that well. However, probably one needs to remember. I don't remember anything. So let me play some move. Maybe a bad move. d6, but I feel like after bishop h3, okay, white is also losing some harmony, so it's possible that what I'm intending to do is not the best, but it looks good enough. I mean, I just felt like I'm just gonna play very simple chess. Yeah, queen d2, knight b6, e d6. I'm planning actually simply to recapture with the queen and claim that. Oops, what do I want to claim? I just realized that what I wanted to claim is wrong. All right. Yes, bishop g7. And I wanted to, for some reason, I thought that white had to take on d6 first. Yeah. And now the whole claim is completely ridiculous. Okay. So White actually got the so-called dream. Now I have to fight against the dream. But I have my own. I have my own play and all my own agenda. Yes, I have these terrible pawns. But okay, now that I got the pawn to f, I'm controlling the e4 square. I try to claim that this is not the end of the world. Bishop c6, clever move, really clever move. I'm giving up. I mean, giving up the e5 was definitely not part of the plan. So what can I do? Can I play rook d8? Okay, let me play rook d8. I need to play rook d6. I need to kick this bishop out from c6. It is just very, very irritating here. Okay, rook d6. I have to try to activate my forces. The bishop on a6 is a terrible piece, yeah? It bites on granite, this beastly c4 pawn structure, so I will have to somehow get this bishop. That's why I'm trying to kick this bishop away, so that I can use the long diagonal for myself. And otherwise, the rook on d6 is some kind of a cemented construction. Yeah, that whenever White plays rook ad1 and challenges me on d6, I can take cd6, which would definitely help me correct my pawn structure. Yeah, rook e7 check. It's kind of expected, rook f7. So takes. Now the bishop is not hanging because of the fork. Yeah, that's correct. That was kind of foreseen, but okay, I go king f6. Yeah, knight e5, correct. So I come back bishop c8. What I promised, yeah, I have to regroup. I have to get this bishop back to life, back to reality. Bishop g2 goes back, yeah. All right, so it's also would be time to get active myself, but getting active might be tricky here. First I will develop this bishop to e6 or not? It's a big question. It's not an easy position to play a tempo, because we both have our pluses and minuses. Okay, also a question, should I? Okay, let me push a5 first. I want to create some weaknesses there. Knight c6. Let's go a4. I want to get rid of this. I mean, maybe not, but yeah, I definitely wanted to get rid of this a7 weakness, just in case, not to run into some tricks. Yeah, now bishop goes to e6. And I feel like I got harmony. I mean, now everything is as I wished, as I pleased. Knight d5 check. Okay, so now the only problem is, how do I play for a win? Because if takes, ba4, it's very, very drawish. It's very, very drawish. So maybe I have to take with the bishop. Takes. I take on b3. I take on d5. Rook c1, exactly correct. And I was counting on some knight b4 business. And then rook d1 check. I really wanted to make this work and then use this pin, but how do I use the pin? It's not so simple to use it. Yeah, so I can't use the pin, so I have to come back. Knight d5. It's a big, big battle because my c-pawn is weak and I would love to somehow activate my king. King d6. protecting the pawn. Want to rely on my good knight. Knight c3. Check. Okay, let's go. Okay, let's go king d7. I actually wanted to play king c5, but I was trying to get this construction. King e3, takes f2, and takes, yeah, it's kind of quite amazing that white has a very, very stable construction. Very, very stable construction. How do I play for a win here? Not easy at all. Not easy at all. G5. G4, wow. That's a stunning move. Oops, I lost on time. Oh my God, yeah, I just completely forgot about the clock. Wow, I just completely forgot about the clock. This is painful. I mean, please give me a rematch, because this one hurts. I was enjoying here so nicely. If I have a chance to get a rematch, then I want a rematch after this game. The computer is trying to get this rematch possible. Well, but this g3 g4 was really a tricky move. I mean, I did not expect. I mean, clearly my opponent had been underrated in this game. Okay, now it's now we will be professional. Now we will be super professional. Not going down on the clock. Absolutely. Wow, but I mean, I feel like my opponent is definitely not 1973. I mean, this just doesn't feel at all like 1973. So let's see what is this. Also, this bishop b7, bishop c5 indicates that maybe somebody is trying to troll me. Maybe somebody is trolling me here. I have this feeling, but you never know. You never know. D6, A3. Trying to, yeah, H6. Logical. Now I will try to play bishop E3. Try to trade these bishops. Castles. Okay. So what does it? Okay, let's go knight D5. Wow, and I lost all my ratings. Okay, wow, yeah, just one game, and then you were fighting here for more than 1.5 hours, gaining. Some games were unrated suddenly, and then you lose one game and you lose all your points. Unbelievable how this system works. Not that rating matters. I mean, we are having fun, but still, I just feel like this was a little bit unexpected. This was just unexpected. You never know exactly. Your opponent has 1900 something, and you just don't know what is happening. Takes. Yeah, and black plays everything correct. I mean, black does everything correctly. King b8. Okay, let me go c4. I have to try to get somewhere something. I have a little bit space advantage. I have this active bishop on d5, which I have to pay attention, not that it will be trapped, but I want to use my momentum with some rook ac1. some ideas like this. Yeah, 98 correct. So I have to take rook b7. Rook ac1. 96. I mean, I really have the feeling that I'm playing against a very good grandmaster. I mean, definitely, I feel like I'm getting taught here. Yeah, g5. Okay. This is showing already confidence or no respect whatsoever. The knight on e6 is a monster knight. That's what I also like. I was mentioning this today, that this kind of knight on g6 or knight on e6, very much in my spirit. So, okay, let me go d4 for the moment. Let me try to open up. g4, I have queen takes h6 check. That's why I'm not minding g4 for the moment. And I want to use this momentum to open up the center. g5, d4. Queen f6, correct. Yeah, d5. d5, rook fd1. Taking control of the d-file. Getting my own play. And of course, black has his own agenda as well. But with the d-file open, I feel that it should be up for me. 91. I want to use the d-file for my benefit. Rook b8, correct. Yeah, immediately my opponent wants to fight for the d-file. Well done, it's correct. It's absolutely correct. So, okay, how do we fight for advantage? Rook d5 feels correct. Look, okay, knight d3 also feels correct. Let me bring the knight. c6, rook d6. Takes. Knight d4, everything comes a tempo and all the moves that I'm basically expecting. This is somehow very, very suspicious. I don't know. This is just a Superman. I mean, I feel like I'm fighting against a Superman. But I'm also not Pacersky myself. So let's fight. Let's fight it out. I still feel like I'm putting some pressure. Rook g8. Is there some attack going on? Do I have to pay attention to something? Yeah, definitely. I mean, it's a little bit irritating. All kinds of watching out for some things. Okay, let me sidestep with my king. Let me play rook f1. Would like to open up the F file. Go F4, Queen G6, stopping. F4, okay, so let me go. Hang on, if I go Knight B7, what happens? So okay, my opponent is, okay, then let me take the exchange. Let me break. F4. Takes. Yeah, 96. I mean, still, this is insane. I mean, this is exactly what I'm talking about. My opponent is just a monster. Queen a7. Slightly nervous reaction what I'm doing, but I'm truly impressed. I'm truly impressed, but yes, now I got it. Whew. I mean, this was very tough. Whew, yeah, okay, guys, yeah, thank you very much. I mean, this was worth it. I mean, it sometimes it hurts to lose a game, but you feel your adrenaline, you feel your blood immediately circulating in your body. I really feel that. Then that's it. I think, guys, yeah, we had wonderful time. I do hope that we don't have to wait for 1.5 years for the next Banter Blitz. I would like to thank all my fans, everyone who is following my commentary, who is following all the action here in Chess24. It's always a pleasure to do this. And I definitely believe that we're going to continue. We're going to continue. Thank you very much. And yes, now that suddenly the World Championship match has ended, I have a little bit more time. I was just way too busy with all the preparation. I do hope that we will get a chance to continue. Thank you very much. See you next time. Bye-bye.